Hello friends and welcome to YouTube channel on Engineering Mathematics by Dr. Navneet. So in this video lecture, we are discussing the property of Laplace transformation, which is called as effect of multiplication by T property. So friends, already we know that. So Laplace transformation of 9 standard results. So these are the 9 standard results. So these 9 standard results are very much useful for solving the example based on the Laplace transformation. So now this effect of multiplication by T property says that Laplace transformation of T raised to n f of t is equal to minus 1 raised to n into nth derivative with respect to s of phi of s, where the value of phi of s is the Laplace transformation of f of t. That means Laplace transformation of f of t is equal to phi of s. So here the value of f of t means this value. So Laplace transformation of this f of t. So now again here question arises, when we have to apply the effect of multiplication by T property. So in this effect of multiplication by T property, so first term is T raised to n. That means if we get the term of the form T square, and second term is, suppose this is sine of 3t. So because of the first term T, its power, we use the effect of multiplication by T property. So or we may write this as T square into cos of 4t. So then because of the power of t or t term, so we use the effect of multiplication by t property. That means whenever to find out the Laplace transformation of two and more than two terms, and out of which one of them term is power of t, then use effect of multiplication by t property. So now to understand this property, so let's take the example. So now here example is that, so example, find Laplace transformation of, suppose, so we take the simple example first. So this is t into sine of at. So now to find out the Laplace transformation, we write this as Laplace transformation of t into sine of at. So this is the given example. So if we compare this given example with the effect of multiplication by t property, then here we get power of t as 1. That means we get the value of n as 1, and that of value of f of t, so value of f of t is sine of at. So this is the value of f of t. So now according to this property, first find out the value of Laplace transformation of f of t and call that value as phi of s. So now take the Laplace transformation of this term. So we write this as Laplace transformation of f of t, which is equal to Laplace transformation of sine of at. So now this is because of the effect of multiplication by t property. Now we know that to find out this Laplace transformation, so this Laplace transformation is directly standard formula number 4, Laplace transformation of sine of at, which is a upon a square plus a square. So we write the value of this term as a upon, this is a square plus a square. So now after finding the value of Laplace transformation of f of t, so according to this property, we denote this by phi of s. So this is the value of our phi of s. Then apply this property. So therefore, by effect of multiplication, by effect of multiplication by t property, so according to this property, we can write this as Laplace transformation of t into sine of at is equal to, so now this property we can apply Laplace transformation of t raised to n f of t is equal to, so we can write this as minus 1 raised to, minus 1 raised to n. So this n, so value of n is 1, so we mentioned that n is equal to 1, so we can write the power of this term as 1 into derivative with respect to s of this term. So we require n the derivative, but here value of n is 1, so we take the first derivative with respect to s of, so this is phi of s, and we know the value of phi of s. So value of phi of s is a upon, this is s square plus a square. So this is the value of phi of s. Now let's simplify this. So now we know that, so minus 1 raised to 1 is 1. So now take the derivative of this, take the derivative of this function with respect to s. So apply u upon v rule. So according to the u upon v rule, so we can write this as denominator square, that means s square plus a square, it's square, then denominator s square plus a square into derivative of numerator, derivative of a which is constant, so derivative of constant is 0, so minus, so we can write this as numerator which is a into derivative of denominator, derivative of s square plus a square which is 2s. So finally, if we simplify this term, then this first term is 0, so we get this as minus 2as upon, this is a square plus a square, then it's square. So this minus minus become plus. So now this is the final answer for the Laplace transformation of t into sine of a t. So we use here effect of multiplication by t property. So this is one of the simple example for learning this property. Now let's take the second example. So second example is t square e raised to minus t into sine of 4t. So now let's try to solve this example with the help of effect of multiplication by t property. Now here the given example, so we can solve this example with the help of two different property. So first property required is effect of multiplication by t property. That means if we write this term as t square, then e raised to minus t into sine of 4t. So this is the value of t raised to n, and this is the value of f of t. So we can directly apply the effect of multiplication by t property, or we may write this term as e raised to minus t into t square sine of 4t. So if we consider this as the one term and this as the second term, then Laplace transformation of e raised to minus a t f of t, so which is equal to phi of s plus a. So that means effect, this is called as first shifting theorem of the Laplace transformation. So now that means this example we can solve with the help of effect of multiplication by t property also, with the help of first shifting theorem of the Laplace transformation. Now here question is that whether we have to apply the first theorem of Laplace transformation, first shifting theorem of Laplace transformation, or effect of multiplication by t property. So friends, according to me, so to do the simple calculation or to get the answer without any complications, so use effect of multiplication by t property. So if we apply this first shifting property, then calculation and some complications may get increased. So that's why we are applying effect of multiplication by t property first. So if we apply this effect of multiplication by t property first, then we can write this as Laplace transformation of t square into e raised to minus t into sine of 4t. So now if we compare this example with the effect of multiplication by t property, then we get here the value of n as 2. So t square, that means we get the value of n as 2, and that of value of f of t, so value of f of t is e raised to minus t into sine of 4t. So we get the value of f of t in this way. Now according to this property, find out the Laplace transformation of f of t and call that value as phi of s. So now if we take the Laplace transformation of f of t, then we get this as Laplace transformation of e raised to minus t into sine of 4t. So now to find out the Laplace transformation of this function, and whatever answer we are getting, that answer is called as phi of s. But here again, so this is the product of two terms, so we cannot apply the standard formula for finding the Laplace transformation because this is the product of two terms. But according to the first shifting theorem, So we know that Laplace transformation of e raised to minus at into f of t is equal to, so we can write this as phi of s plus a. So that means we have to apply the first shifting theorem of the Laplace transformation for finding the Laplace transformation of product of two terms, and out of them first term is exponential function. That's why we are applying first shifting theorem of the Laplace transformation. So now if we apply this theorem to this term, then we get that, so we know that Laplace transformation of sine of 4t, so this Laplace transformation is 4 upon s square plus, this is 4 square, that means 4 for the 16. So we apply the standard result number 4, Laplace transformation of sine of at is equal to a upon s square plus a square. Here the value of a is 4. Now this is the value of phi of s according to the first shifting theorem. Now this theorem says that add term a to the parameter s. So here the value of a, if we compare this term and this term, then we get the value of a as 1. That means add 1 to the parameter s. So then we can write the Laplace transformation of this function as, so 4 upon, this is s plus 1, its square, plus 16. So from this step we get this step because of the first shifting theorem of the Laplace transformation. So for this, first find out the value of Laplace transformation of sine of 4t, phi of s, and in this phi of s replace s by s plus a, where a is equal to 1. So that's why we write this step. So now just simplify this step, so we get this as 4 upon, this is s square plus 2s plus 1 and plus 60, that means we can directly write this as plus 70. So this is the value of Laplace transformation of f of t, and according to this Laplace transformation of f of t, call this value as phi of s. So we can call this value as phi of s. So this is the value of phi of s. Now after finding the value of phi of s, so we can directly apply the effect of multiplication by t property. So by effect of multiplication by t property, so according to this property, so we can write this as Laplace transformation of, so our aim is to find out this term, so Laplace transformation of t square e raised to minus t into sine of 4t. So according to this property, so this property says that, so we can write this as, so which is equal to minus 1 raised to n. So here the value of n, that means t power, so value of t power is 2, that means n is equal to 2, so we can write this as minus 1 raised to 2 into, so we can write this as second derivative with respect to s of phi of s. So this is the value of phi of s, so we can write this as 4 upon s square plus 2s plus 70. So this is the value of phi of s. So once again friends, try to understand that here. So we can write this as minus 1 raised to 2, because value of n, after comparing this power of t, we get value of n as 2. So we can write this as minus 1 raised to 2, then second derivative with respect to s of phi of s, this is the value of phi of s. That means take 2 derivative of this function, so that we get the final answer for this step. So we know that, so this is minus 1 raised to 2, anything raised to even power is plus, anything raised to even power is plus, so we can write this as 1. Then if we take the first derivative of this function, so if we take the first derivative of this function, then we get this as s square plus 2s plus 17, then its square. That means we apply here the concept of derivative of u upon v rule. So according to the u upon v rule, so denominator square, then denominator, so value of denominator is s square plus 2s plus 17, this is denominator, into derivative of numerator, derivative of 4, which is constant, is 0, then
So we can write this as minus numerator, that means 4, into derivative of denominator. So derivative of denominator is 2s plus 2. So this is 2s plus 2. So if we simplify this equation, then we get next step as, so if we try to simplify this term, then we get next step as, so derivative with respect to s of, so this first step is 0 because this is multiplied by 0. So if we multiply this 4 to the inner side, then we get this as minus 8s minus 8 divided by, so this is s square plus 2s plus 17, it's square. So after simplifying this term, that means, so here we find the first derivative with respect to s. So from this equation, so we may take, so we may take minus 8 common. So if we take minus 8 common from the numerator, then remaining term is d by ds of, this is s plus 1. So because we are taking minus 8 as common, then value of denominator is s square plus 2s plus 17, it's square. So now according to this step, so take one more derivative so that we get the final answer of this question. So now if we simplify further, that means if we take one more derivative, then we get this as denominator square. Again apply the u upon v rule, so take the denominator square, so here square is already present, d square plus 2s plus 70, already square is present, again take one more square, so power of this denominator term is 4. Then denominator, that means this is s square plus 2s plus 70, so this is denominator, it's square, denominator, into derivative of numerator, derivative of s plus 1 with respect to s is 1, minus numerator, so value of numerator is s plus 1, into derivative of this denominator, so derivative of denominator is, so we can write this as 2 times, this is s square plus 2s plus 70, but this is other than s, so again take the derivative of s square plus 2s plus 70, so we get this as 2s plus 2. So in this way we take the derivative of this function. So once again simplify this, minus 8 as it is, so take the denominator as it is. So now here observe that s square plus 2s plus 70, again this term is here, again this term is also available in the denominator. So if we cancel one term from first and second term of numerator and from denominator, so then we get the value of denominator as s square plus 2s plus 17, it's q. So because we cancel one term, so then in numerator we get this value as, so we get this value as s square then plus 2s plus 17, one power is cancelled, then minus, so this is 2, so this is 2, so now this term is cancelled, so simplify the term, s plus 1 and 2s plus 2, so if we take the product of this term, then we get this as 2s square, then this is 2s square plus 2s, again this is 2s plus 2, that means finally if we simplify this term, then we get the answer of this term as 2s square plus 4s plus 2. So after simplifying this term, we get the step of calculation. Now, see here, observe that once again simplify the numerator. So we get the value of numerator as minus 8 constant as it is. This is s square, then this is minus 4s square. So we can write the answer of this term as, so minus 3s square. Then next term is 2s and this is minus 8s, that means this is minus 6s. So this is 4 to the 8, so 2 minus 6. Again, if we collect the constant, then this is minus 4 and this is 17. So we can write this as plus 13. So this whole thing divided by s square plus 2s plus 17, then it's
cube. So in this way we get the answer. So if we take this 8 to the inner side, or if we multiply by 8 to this term, so this minus minus become plus, so 8 threes are, or we may take this minus sign only common, or we may multiply this 8 to the inner side, so we get this as 8 into 3 s square plus 6 s minus 13 divided by, this is s square plus 2 s plus 17, it's cube. So this is the final answer of this question. So you may take this 8 to the inner side. Now this is the second example, which is based on the effect of multiplication by T property. Now let's take the third example. Now friends, let's solve the next critical example. Find the Laplace transformation of T, then we can write this as e raised to T into, so we take the critical example, so we can write this as sine square of 3t. So if we try to solve this example, so take the Laplace transformation of this function, we write this as t e raised to t into, this is sine square of 3t. So again here, effect of multiplication by t property is applicable, because this first term is t, so power of t is 1, so value of n is 1. So according to this property, so we write this as minus 1 raised to n and so on. For this, find the value of f of t. So here the value of f of t is equal to e raised to t into sine square of 3t. So now first find out the Laplace transformation of this function. So Laplace transformation of this function f of t is equal to Laplace transformation of e raised to t into, this is sine square of 3t. So now here first term is e raised to t, so we have to apply the first shifting theorem for finding the Laplace transformation of this function. But here this is sine square of 3t, so we know that, so sine square of t is equal to 1 minus cos of 2t upon 2. So if we write this term, then we write this expression as e raised to t, so in bracket, so this is 1 minus, this is cos of 3 to the 60 upon 2. So now find out this Laplace transformation. So we express sine square as 1 minus cos 60 upon 2, so because of this formula, because this is not in our standard formula. Now here if we take 1 upon 2 constant, then we get this as Laplace transformation of e raised to t, e raised to t into 1 is e raised to t, then middle sign is minus, then Laplace transformation of e raised to t into cos of 60. Now this is the expression. So now just simplify this, so we get this as 1 upon 2, then Laplace transformation of e raised to t according to the first result is 1 upon s minus a, that means s minus 1 minus, so here we have to apply first shifting theorem for the Laplace transformation, then Laplace transformation of cos of 60, so we write this as s upon s square plus 6 is 36. So this is the value of 5 of s, so then according to the first shifting theorem, so we write this as s minus a, so this is s minus 1 upon, this is s minus 1 its square plus 36. So we write this step according to the first shifting theorem of the Laplace transformation. So this is phi of s, so we subtract a from s, value of a is 1. So now if we simplify this term, then we get this as 1 upon 2, 1 upon s minus 1 minus s minus 1 upon, this is s square minus 2s plus 1 plus 36, that means this is plus 37. So this is the value of Laplace transformation of f of t. So let's call this as phi of s. Now this is the value of f of t, so according to this property we get the value of phi of s. Now apply the effect of multiplication by t property, so that we get the answer to this question as, now next step is, so therefore Laplace transformation of t e raised to minus t sine square of 3t is equal to, according to this property, we write this as minus 1 dash 2, power of t is 1, so this is 1 into d by ds of Laplace transform, this is phi of s. So value of phi of s is, so 1 upon 2, so this is 1 upon 2, and in bracket this is 1 upon s minus 1 minus s minus 1 upon this is s square minus 2s plus 37. So now this is the value of this function. Now this Laplace transformation is over. So now just simplify this term. So this is minus 1 dash 2 is minus. So here 1 upon 2 is constant outside the term. So we write this as d by ds of 1 upon s minus 1. This is the first term. Then this is minus again d by ds of s minus 1 upon this is s square minus 2s plus 37. Now just simplify this term. So if we try to simplify this term, then we get next step as minus 1 upon 2 constant. So then derivative of this term with respect to s, u upon v rule again. So s minus 1 is square. So s minus 1 into 0 minus 1 into 1. So then this is the first term minus again derivative of this term. So this is s square minus 2s plus 37, it's square. Then denominator, so this is s square minus 2s plus 37. So this is the first term into derivative of s minus 1 is 1. Again minus numerator s minus 1, derivative of denominator. So this is 2s minus 2, 2s minus 2. So now just simplify this term. So we will reach to the final answer. So this is minus 1 upon 2. So value of this term is 1. So we write this as minus 1 upon s minus 1, it's square. Then this is minus. So we write this as s square minus 2s plus 37 minus. So this is s minus 1 and 2s minus 2. So we write this as 2s square minus 2s minus 2s plus 2. So final answer of this term is 2s square minus 4s plus 2. So this whole thing divided by this is s square minus 2s plus 37, it's square. Now just simplify this term again. So we get this as minus 1 upon 2 as it is. Then this is, so if we take this to the inner side, then we may get this sign may get changed. Minus 1 upon s minus 1 x square, this is minus. Then this is s square minus 2s square, so we get this as minus s square. So this is minus s square, and this is minus 2s, and this is plus 2s. That means we get this as plus 2s. Then this is plus 37 minus 2. That means this is plus 35. This whole thing divided by s square minus 2s plus 37, it's square. Now take this 1 upon 2 minus to the inner side. So we get this as minus minus plus 1 upon 2 into s minus 1, it's square. Again this is minus minus plus 1 upon 2. And if we take minus sign common again here, then this sign will get changed. This is s square minus 2s minus 35, so divided by s square minus 2s plus 37, it's square. So this is the final answer to this question. So now in this way, so we will solve a number of examples which is based on effect of multiplication by T property. So now let's take some example for your practice. Now friends, time is to test your knowledge. So to understand this effect of multiplication by T property, so let's solve this as the example for your practice purpose. So this is the first example, second of two, eighth example. So these examples are very simple, solve at your own level. So I think we will stop here. So thanks to one and all for patiently listening this lecture. So thank you.